Well, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Midgard Golf. So we're out here today in Peyton, Colorado, playing Antler Creek, which is the longest course in Colorado from the tips, which we elected not to play today, so we're playing from a few tee boxes up. So just over 6,400 yards is what we're playing, but the course reaches all the way out to 8,068 or something like that. So, yeah, pretty serious if you want a long drive challenge of a course. But we're not doing that. But we'll still give you the scenes anyway. So, this first hole. Let's see here. From our tee boxes, 332 to get up on this green, dogleg left. You can see the green way out there in the middle of the screen right now. So, the big bomber play from this tee box is to take it right over that left corner and land it out somewhere close. And the safe play is just to probably play something like a long iron. Straight out, and then probably have yourself around, 150 in or so. So that might be what I do. I might just take the deuce and kind of smack it out there and put a little bit of drawski on it if I can. So let's give it a crack and check it out. Here we are in the second hole. Big old par 5, 479 yards. Actually, on my watch, I've got 490 from where we stand right next to the tee box to get up on this green. So nice and big and long, like this course promises. Kind of a swervy hole. Goes out to the right and then back to the left. Bunch of bunkers on both sides. So, yeah, just pipe one and try to stay out of those death traps and you should be all right. Let's give it a whack. Check it out. Thank you. But here on the third hole, big old par four, 417 on the card, but only 365 on my GPS. So seems like it's playing a little bit shorter today than it typically does. So big dog leg left, tons of bunkers in the back. And then as you make that turn, you've got another bunker on the left, or yeah, I can't really tell from here. Might be kind of in front of the green, but yeah, plenty of bunkers to get caught up in. So just stay out of those and hit a nice big old drive over this ravine here and you'll be all right. Let's give it a whack. Check it out. Everybody, here we are back on the fourth hole. Getting a little windy out here now, so sorry about that. You can't really hear me all that much. Try to cover it up for you. So yeah, that last hole I was actually reading the wrong line. We played it around the correct yardage. Actually, we played it 10 yards longer, not shorter, from our tee boxes. So correction on that. But this hole, 353 yards I've got on the watch. So yeah, I mean, pretty straight up hole after this tee shot, which kind of causes for a very early dog leg left, unless you just take the left line straight over the brush, that native fescue. So, yeah, I mean, pretty much play whatever you want here, but, you know, mind you, 350. So, yeah, if you lay up short, well, you're just going to have to deal with it on the second. Let's give it a whack. Check it out. Thank you. so here we are on the fifth hole. Finally, a little par three, a little reprieve, a little short stuff. Nice big green to aim at, too, so that's nice. But kind of oddly shaped, so that's weird. But anyway, about 160 yards to get up on the middle of this green, front of it 139. So, yeah, I'm probably taking a nice pitching wedge at it, as it looks like that pin's kind of in the back a little ways, but I can't really tell. Oh, no, actually, it's in the front, watching the gent putt in front of us. So, maybe the gap wedge is the club here. So, yeah, anyway, let's get up there, give it a whack, and check it out. Everybody, so here we are on the sixth hole, about 400 yards to get up on this green. Pretty straight up, actually. Kinda dogs a little bit to the left after the drive length at around 150 out. So, yeah, but kind of a narrow fairway. So, definitely want to pipe one here. You got bunkers guarding both sides, obviously. So, don't screw it up. Let's give it a whack and check it out. All right, everybody. So here we are on the seventh hole. Big old par five. Even from these white tees here, which is a few tees up, it's still 566 yards to get up on this green. So big old hole. Really have no idea how it's shaped. It looks like it kind of weaves like the last one out to the right and then back to the left. So yeah, I think a good driver's the play, but if you really pump one, you don't want to be out far to the right, because I think missing long here is definitely an option. So yeah, definitely keep it left. Matter of fact, yeah, I do see some fairway right in the middle of the screen out to the left over those bunkers. So yeah, I think that's my line. Try to pump it out there, and yeah, I don't know if this is going to be a two-shot gettable hole. Probably not, but well, miracles happen. Let's give it a whack and check it out. All right, everybody, here we are on the eighth hole. Another par three. About the same as the last one, really. About $160 to get up on this green. Obvious water to clear, so, yep, watch out for that. Don't hit it short. Yeah, the left here is, the miss here is definitely left. Yeah, that's what I wanted to say. Yeah, everything to the right's bad. So, yeah, that's what we're going to try to do. Well, we're going to try to put it in that hole, but if we miss, then hopefully we miss left. Let's give it a whack. Check it out. Bye. So here we are on the ninth hole, on the final hole of this first part of this two-part series out here at Antler Creek in Payton, Colorado. Thank you so much for watching today. Throw us a like and subscribe if you feel. And if not, thank you for showing up anyway. We appreciate your time. So, this hole, par 4, 415 yards on the GPS, tons of bunkers out there, just an ocean of them out to the right side, so definitely the play is left, right in the middle of the screen right now, so yeah, kind of a course management hole here, might end up having to force kind of a long shot in. So actually, no, I see the green now, it's the green's on the left side anyway, so yeah, that's the line no matter what that you really want to take. So, but that is a very narrow line. So let's get up there, give it a whack, check it out. Thank you.